folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and here are 8 of the best cheap guitars of 2021 that don't suck. You know, you're a lucky bunch if you want to start playing guitar in 2021, because when I started playing guitar many, many moons ago, cheap guitars kind of sucked, but now you can get an amazing guitar for not a lot of money these days. And actually, this is the third video we've done on cheap guitars that don't suck. I will link the first one and the second one down in the description box down below on the pop-out banner somewhere on screen right now. And in those original videos, I go through like Squier Bullet, Telecasters and Affinity Stratocasters, some Epiphone gear, and like some starter packs and whatnot. So I've already covered a lot of guitars in this series, let's call it. So today, for the 2021 installment, I have goodies from Kramer, Ibanez, Epiphone, Squier, Encore, and Gretsch. I'm using 2 tech cables into a Daddario chromatic tuner, going into a Blackstar HT Stage 100 Watt Mark II head. Now this looks like you're using a big fancy stack to make these sound good. What I love about Blackstar is the fact that their big 100 watt HT heads sound exactly the same as the little HT 5 watt combos. It's just the fact that this is bigger and I'm in a guitar store, so of course I was gonna use the big stupid one, but it does sound the same as the small little combos. There's so many more amazing cheap guitars that don't suck out there these days. I've only got 8 right now. You don't wanna hear me harping on for 4 hours about cheap guitars. So please feel free to comment down below your favorite cheap guitar, maybe the guitar you started out on and why you love it so much. And I might include that in the next cheap guitars that don't suck video. Also, I'm not gonna mention any specific prices in this video as prices fluctuate even by like a quid every now and then. So all the links for the guitars are in the description box down below for you to check them out at pmtonline.co.uk. With that, some of them are going to be super affordable, like £99, like this Encore Strat behind me. Some of them are a bit more expensive, all under 500 quid. That is still a lot of money, but I will explain why they don't suck and why they're worth the money, because they're emulating something that's thousands and thousands of pounds, but we'll get to that shortly. Let's get started with this glorious Ibanez. This is an Ibanez GRX 70QA because it's got a lovely quilted top. Now, this is one of the GO series from Ibanez, and for over 20 years, the GO series from Ibanez has been showing us that you haven't got to spend a lot of money to sound and look fantastic. Now, the whole crack with this guitar is I love the way it looks, and that's why I put it in this list. When it comes to choosing your first guitar, it's got to look good. Like, that's the whole point of playing guitar. You want to stand in front of the mirror and be like, yeah, this guitar is fantastic. I look cool. I want to be on stage. And these Ibanez GRX 70s come in a myriad of beautiful colors, purple, red, and this is the blue one. And it's gorgeous, but it's also very versatile. Having this HSH configuration, so humbucker, single coil humbucker, means you can get pretty much every single sound you would want out of an electric guitar. So that big, thick, chunky humbucker tone. But also some beautiful single coil tones. Nice and spanky when you want to get your Jimi Hendrix on. So, 5-way switch, bridge pickup, inside single coils to get some more twang, individual middle pickup, the 2 inner coils on the neck and the middle, and finally that lovely neck humbucker. One volume, one tone. The body itself is poplar, and it's contoured in a beautiful way. So it is that classic S-type double cut, but it's a bit softer and a bit pointier for the whole Ibanez rock and roll aesthetic. And the quilt maple on top, it is maple, but it's actually a photograph. It's not actually a quilted maple. So it's actually printed onto wood. So it looks like it's more expensive than it actually is, because it's not a lot of money. 25.5-inch scale, a beautiful flat fingerboard, proper Ibanez fingerboard. It's actually treated New Zealand pine on the fingerboard for this, so it's very sustainable to the planet, but also allows your fingers to glide across and shred people's brains out, just like Mr. Steve Vai or Joe Satriani or whichever your favorite Ibanez player is. I think that's all the specs. Let's hear it some more. Oh, and it's got a trem. So let's hear some dirt first before we hear some clean tones. We'll be right back. pickups do really sing. These are Ibanez's own Affinity pickups, and they're gorgeous. They sound just as nice on clean too. Go from that, it's too bloody. I love these guitars. I wish they were around when I first started out. That was a GRX 70TB in transparent blue burst. This is the Squier Affinity Telecaster Deluxe. Now the Squier Affinities have been around for many, many moons. Again, I think in the first Cheap Guitars That Don't Suck video, I play one, a much younger looking, slightly thinner version of myself from 3 years ago. But this wasn't around back then. The Tele Affinity Deluxe is only a recent model from Squier, and they've absolutely nailed this iconic look, feel and vibe, but for not a lot of money. This lovely example is in Burgundy Mist, and it's a glorious looking thing. Look at it, it's fantastic. Poplar body, maple neck, and as you see, the body is nice and shiny, but the back of the neck is actually satin, so similar to the Ibanez. It's just a bit smoother under your hand, where sometimes painted necks can get a bit claggy if you're sweating on stage and stuff. Personally, I enjoy a painted neck, but it's not for everyone. But the attention to detail, the front of the headstock is lacquered and shiny and stuff, but it's the back which is soft and smooth and silky. Indian Laurel fingerboard, more curved radius, it's more of a vintage feeling guitar than the Ibanez. The whole chat with the Tele Deluxes back in the day was Fender made Telecasters with single coils. Everybody enjoys that. But the Les Paul had two humbuckers and a switch up here and stuff down here. So the Tele Deluxe was Fender's kind of whack at a Les Paul. And they've kind of nailed it. They've always nailed it. They've got their own unique tone because of the string through bridge, as you can see here. These are two ceramic pickups. There's 21 medium jumbo frets, well, that was 22 on the Ibanez. Toggle switches up here. One volume for each pickup, one tone for each pickup. And this is the neck pickup, it's glorious. I'm trying to play similar things on each guitar so you can get the vibe of them all. So the pickups are less output than the Infinities on the Ibanez, but they're, like, again, just vintage sounding. Very precise, clean, dynamic sounding pickups. Thank you. And that pickup's gorgeous, isn't it? Go from jazz to... And that, ladies and gentlemen, was the Squier Affinity Telecaster Deluxe. This is an Epiphone SG61 with the Vibrola. Now this is up towards the higher end of a cheap guitar that doesn't suck, but I really wanted to talk about it because the Gibson SG is my favorite guitar of all time. And it's iconic, this look is iconic, and this is the closest thing you can get to that iconic red Angus Young, Tony Iommi guitar without spending thousands of pounds. Now in the original cheap guitars that don't suck video, I included the SG G400 by Epiphone, which was the old SG essentially. Gibson and Epiphone are a totally different entity these days. They've been totally revamped for the best. That original guitar was fantastic, but now they're pumping out guitars like you've never seen before. As an SG nerd, there's way more to this guitar than just an SG. So there's the standard SG and the 61. The 61 has slightly different horns. The neck tenon is slightly further back. It's just a joy to play, and for a couple of hundred quid, you can get something which is iconic and yeah, I love SGs. Anyways, the specs on this bad lad, exactly what you'd expect. Mahogany body, set mahogany neck, it's Epiphone's slim taper profile neck. You've got the new Kalamazoo headstock up top. 12-inch radius, Indian Oral fingerboard, so a proper Gibson radius fingerboard. 22 medium jumbo frets. Down on the body, you've got two Epiphone Pro Buckers, the 2 and the 3. Very vintage PAF sounding. I know people kick off when you say PAF sounding, but it's that lovely, warm, sweet kind of tone. Nailed it with these. These actually have the same 18% nickel content as the original ones, and they're from the original factory. Anyways, more nerdy stuff. I chose this one with the Vibrola because SGs look the best they've ever looked with this Vibrola. All my SGs have these Vibrolas on, and I think they're fantastic. These are very close as well, by the way. If this was a nitrocellulose finish as opposed to poly, they'd be nigh on identical. CTS pots in the new inspired by Gibson range as well, so only the best of the best. Orange drop capacitors too, so spec-wise, these pots are going to outlive all of us. Can I just say as well, all the Epiphone inspired by Gibson range guitars are just fantastic, not just the SG. So if you look at, if you're a Slash fan and you want a Les Paul but you can't afford a proper Les Paul, if you get the inspired by Gibson Epiphone, you're really close there. You're really, really close there to that proper Gibson feel and vibe, and they've nailed it. I mean, just look at that. Crikey Moses. It's gorgeous. And luckily, it's got all the tones to back it up too. These big Vibrola tailpieces as well do make the SG feel different. The string tension is different because the way it's anchored to the body, and it adds a lot of mass. These things are quite heavy, SGs are usually light anyways, but when you add this weight to the body, it gives it a little bit of twang, a little bit of secret sauce, and a little bit more sustain, even though they just rang like a bell and have beautiful sustain anyways. Show you the neck pickup, shouldn't I? hard not just to play loads of AC/DC riffs. They're just a joy to play. You've got to get yourself to a PMT store and really feel these inspired by Gibson Epiphones. It's the best they've ever made. This is the Ibanez Gem Junior in shocking pink. Same as the Epiphone I've just been chatting about. I've put this in this list and it's a bit more expensive than a really cheap guitar, but it's totally worth it because it's that look, feel, vibe of that iconic signature Steve Vai Ibanez Gem, but it doesn't cost $3,500. And recently, last year I think, they brought out these amazing colors because Steve is known for his white Ibanez Gem. That was the first Gem Junior to come out. But the original Gems that were released in 1987, the Gem 777s, came out in pink, yellow, and green. And now with the Gem Juniors, you can get this neon pink and neon yellow as well as the white one. There's not a green one yet, but I really hope there's one coming in the future. Now, if you were to buy one of these and you're a big Steve Vai fan, you spend a couple more hundred quid to get the Damasio Evolution pickups, and maybe it's a better Ibanez tremolo. You've essentially got that same guitar. It's got the monkey grip, it's got the Tree of Life inlay, and it's just a joy to play. One spec that is different though, mahogany body, which is quite odd for the Gem, but it works, it sounds good, and I think Steve wanted a different flavor because Steve Vai actually plays these Gem Juniors quite a bit at home and sometimes live. So I think the mahogany Gem was just kind of a different kind of thing because he made the woody Gem recently, and then, yeah, again, more geek stuff. Ibanez Infinity pickups, the same as what you find in the GRX70, but these are pink because why not? One volume, one tone, five-way switch. You've got the monkey grip and everything is contoured, just like an Ibanez Gem should be, so much so, even the input jack goes in from the top as opposed to down the bottom, so when you stand on your cable, it doesn't get pulled out. It has a beautiful thin maple neck, 24 jumbo frets as well, so full 2-octave range on the Tree of Life fretboard, exactly the same as what's on Big Stevie Vai's. Matching fluorescent pink headstock. Now this thing is like, it glows pink. It is, hopefully the camera does it justice, but when you see it in person, it's like, Jesus Christ, that's absolutely crackers. What's even more crackers as well, is it has a tremolo. Double locking tremolo, like a Floyd Rose system or Ibanez Edge, what Ibanez called this double locking system. And this means it locks up at the top with some Allen keys. So if you were rocking your GRX, the wire bar a bit too hard, same as a Stratocaster, it might go out of tune a little bit. But with these locking systems, you get to do stuff like this. And the guitar stays perfectly in tune. You can be subtle with it, of course, as well, like Steve Vai when he does the whole, you know. That looks like going crackers with it. That's all the specs on the Gem Junior in fluorescent pink. It's gorgeous. Let's hear it some more with some dirty tones, then some clean tones. Modulated between like four keys there, but it's totally fine when you play a Gem because it makes it look like you know what you're doing and it makes it look like it's deliberate. The position four there is that lovely inner coil of the neck Infinity pickup and the middle coil to get that kind of. I'm not gonna play too much Steve Vai because copyright police will get me, but. On a clean sound. So when it's locked up here, if you've never used the locking tremolo before, these little fine tuners are like off a violin. and they fine-tune the string because it goes a bit sharp or flat. Well, sharp when you lock it into the top here. These now don't work. The Ibanez Gem Jr. and why it's so awesome. The Gretsch Streamliner G2210 Junior Jet. And it's a glorious guitar. There's been very similar guitars from Gretsch in the past with this single cut, almost Les Paul Junior-esque vibe. But this is the latest, it's a Streamliner, and it also comes in vintage white, which looks absolutely amazing, and that was the one I was gonna use in this video, but someone bought it like 20 minutes ago. So now I've got this equally as gorgeous greeny blue one. I love these kind of stripped back rock and roll guitars. Simply two bits of wood bolted together, a couple of humbuckers, not a lot of controls, and the strings are bolted directly to the body. Single wraparound tailpiece with the fancy intonation lightning bolt to help your guitar stay intonated. You've also got the two little grub screws down the bottom there. These are Gretsch Broadtron pickups, so they look like Filtertrons, that classic kind of Gretsch look, but they're actually humbuckers, so they're a lot more versatile than your traditional Filtertron. Knob-wise, it's pretty cool. Massive volume over here on the left. It's kind of a staple for Gretsch guitars to have the massive volume, like, really accessible. And a tone control over where usually the volume would be. Switch up here. The body and neck are made of NATO, which is part of the mahogany family, so just like a more sustainable version of mahogany. Same kind of tonal characteristics. Beautiful, vintage-looking Indian laurel fingerboard. 12-inch radius, 22 medium jumbo frets with a nice little thumbnail inlays on the side. Classic Gretsch headstock, and what I love about these guitars for the price, the whole guitar is painted. This is called gunmetal, by the way, this color. A lot of affordable, let's say, guitars only paint the front and the back's all black or natural or something. Gretsch have gone all out with this. This is like a beautiful, it's like if the Gibson Les Paul Jr. was made in Vegas. Gretsch always like to put cool fancy appointments on, and it's set off beautifully with this tortoiseshell pickguard. It's a lot of guitar. No, it's a lot of guitar. It's not a lot of guitar because there's not a lot going on, but it's a lot of tone, but not a lot of money. We'll be right back. a cool shaped neck on this. It's like a U shape, but not as intense as like an old Telecaster or something. And that is the Gretsch Streamliner G2210 Junior Jet, and why it doesn't suck for the price. This is the Squier Contemporary Telecaster, and just look at it. This is a Squier, and it's got a bloody roasted maple neck. For a couple of hundred quid, you can get something which essentially looks, feels, and plays like a custom shop Fender. It's madness, this guitar, and the rest of the Contemporary range as well. There's Contemporary Starcasters, a really funky looking Stratocaster. But this is my favorite because it's just gorgeous. Pearl white, binding all around the body, and that roasted maple neck. You've got a lovely contour heel, so you can get to that 22nd medium jumbo fret, no problem at all. What looks like a single coil on the bridge is actually a hot rail Squier humbucker. Full humbucker in the neck, one volume, one tone, but you'll notice this is backwards. So the volume is the first thing you see, and the pickup selector is over here, as opposed to the other way around. That gorgeous body itself is made out of poplar, so it's very, really light and resonant. Matching headstock with the Squier logo up top. Black hardware, black tuners, black string through bridge. It's like a hot rodded Telecaster, and you'll struggle to find anything with this kind of spec for this price. A couple of little modifications, like maybe Seymour Duncan or DiMarzio pickups, a couple of coil taps, and you've got yourself one hell of a top shelf guitar, but this is a great base to start. I wouldn't change anything on this guitar. I think it's amazing. It is a humbucker in the bridge. It's not super spicy. Lovely neck as well. It's a 12-inch radius fingerboard, which is quite unique for Fender. They're usually 9.5 or 7.5 for more vintage kind of things. So it's a flatter, more Gibson-ish radius, but it's very pleasant to play. And that is the Squier Contemporary Telecaster in all of its roasted glory. this is the Encore E6 in vintage white. And I'm very, very pleasantly surprised at this guitar. All the other affordable guitars I talk about in this video, I was like, the Encore is probably going to need a setup out of the box. This is a brand that's been renowned for great beginner guitars for many, many years. But they actually had a revamp last year, I believe, and they're very similar to that vintage brand. It plays lovely out the box, you know. It's light as a feather. Super light, a very, very familiar shape. Obviously, the playing of the whole Strat thing. It's actual rosewood fingerboard as well. So these affordable guitars have Indian Laurel fretboards and Jatoba fretboards. This is an actual rosewood fingerboard with 22 frets. It's just a joy to play as well. So it's a satin back of the neck. The fit and finish as well is great. Again, I was expecting like some sharp frets and stuff. Nah, absolutely blown away. Very surprising. So the front of the headstock is lovely and glossy. The back of the neck is nice and satin. Like I said, it's a lovely feel for the beginners out there. It's not too claggy and tacky. Pickup wise, three single coils. Again, it's a proper kind of Strat vibe. Really good, that position too. Not at the bridge pickup. But I think I was pleasantly surprised at that as well. It's not too ice picky. A lot of affordable Strat copies, the bridge pickup is notoriously really ice picky, and sometimes it's a bit too bright to play on a clean channel, but I think it's absolutely gorgeous. Tremolo as well, when you want to get your spaghetti western on, one volume and two tones. I can't get over how lightweight it is, and the whole thing kind of resonates when you play big chords. That neck pickup's gorgeous. You know, Slow Dancing was actually played on the middle pickup. A lot of people know that. Let's see what it sounds like with some dirt. Can he sustain for a guitar that's under 100 quid, like? Like, this is kind of blowing me away. I wanted to include this guitar because it's under £100, and for the money, you get a lot of guitar and craftsmanship here, but I didn't think I would enjoy it this much. So this is great for beginners. It's a cheap guitar that doesn't suck. However, it's also a very cheap guitar to modify. Like, the neck is lovely. Get yourself some fancy humbuckers or something and turn this into an absolute beast. I really want to guitar spin it because it weighs nothing, and it's a great guitar to guitar spin. Love this guitar, the Encore E6 in vintage white. This is a Kramer Focus, the VT211 to be precise, and it's one of my favorite affordable guitars on the planet, hands down, because I'm in love with the brand Kramer. I wouldn't play guitar or in turn have this job now if it wasn't for this guitar company. The first people I saw do something on a guitar, and I had no idea what they were doing. I was like, what the hell is they doing on that guitar? They always had Kramer on the headstock. This was the guitar brand of the 80s. Eddie Van Halen, Mick Mars, all of my idols play these Kramer guitars, and now you can too for just over 100 quid. The Kramer Focus is affordable, versatile, and yeah, has that iconic name on the old headstock. A matching headstock, I must say. This is ruby red, also comes in a lovely shade of teal, and also as a cool player pack, but I'll be reviewing that in a slightly different video. That classic S-type double cut design, super comfortable, whether you're sitting down, standing up, have your guitar low, have your guitar high, it's just a great thing. Humbucker in the bridge for that classic 80s, when you want to play every Van Halen song under the sun. And two single coils when you want to get your Stevie Ray Vaughan on. Five-way switch, one volume, two tones, a beautiful satin. Again, satin is a common theme, beautiful common theme, I must add. Slim taper Kramer neck, 12-inch radius fingerboard with 21 medium jumbo frets. It's got a tremolo. It's awesome. Here's how it sounds. There we have it, ladies and gentlemen. 8 cheap guitars for 2021 that don't suck. That was a lot of fun, and if you've lasted this long into the video, please comment down below your favorite or what you might want to add. Because again, there's so many guitars out there these days that are just fantastic for the price. I wish these were around when I first started playing guitar. I'd be a lot better now, I'd tell you that. I bet you're sick of the same riffs of this, however long this video is. But yeah, it's been a lot of fun. Everything is linked down below in the description box. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on any of the products I've chatted about here today, get yourself to your local PMT store or click the link in the description box to take yourself to PMTonline.co.uk. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and now TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.